out. Done. All the social media set up and software testing is complete. Electronic payment system's ready. It's all working, Julian. We're a go, buddy.
Fucking way, Buzz. You know what? You are the fucking man, buddy.
Oh, I know I'm the fucking man. I mean, I honestly don't think there's a snowball's chance of fucking hell this business is gonna work, but I did my best. Here we go.
Cream was like had the sort of bare
Cream is metal. Yeah,
in the Bhagavad Gita, baby. Don't you know that we are live here once again, another Yakov stream with the gang. We got Jack here. What's up, homie?
What's up, y'all?
We got Polak. See if Flame pops in later. See if anyone else joins us for this wonderful evening. This beautiful, almost Halloween evening. It's almost Halloween. Happy almost Halloween.
Got my Halloween arm shirt on.
I got a new hobby. I'm watching old creepy silent movies with synthwave playing over it.
Hell yeah.
Eat a tab of acid and vibe to that, dog. I certainly will.
Definitely.
What are you guys doing for Halloween? What are your costumes? You gotta get costumes.
I gotta do some kind of superhero shit, I guess.
Some kind of superhero shit. Come on, liven that up a little bit. Sounds lame. My mom would want to make that costume for you.
Spawn.
Spawn.
Come on.
God. Spawn's actually one of the more based options. Like, I'm not gonna lie.
No, I don't know. Like, how about Batman with like a broken spine, and you're in the costume, and you're wheeling around in a wheelchair.
Heath Ledger Joker.
Oh no! Too many people did that. Nobody should ever do that shit again.
Society for Halloween.
Fuck, man! I wish I had a reason to dress up. I'm not going to any Halloween thing, as far as I know. Yeah, I gotta find one. I wanted to do Fright Fest at Six Flags because I love roller coasters, and I forget how much I love roller coasters till I'm on roller coasters. I'm like, this shit's for me, dog. I do this.
Chivalry. You know about Azrael, the Batman, like the other Batman?
Hell no, dude. I don't know anything about Batman, really. I watched some lore videos. Some of them were good. Like, some of the parallel dimension Batmans were really cool. Mm-hmm. Like, the Batman that laughs or whatever, where he's, like, the Joker. Mm-hmm. That shit is dope. I like Punisher Batman, who, like, shoots people specifically.
Oh, the Punisher. That's
pretty funny.
Yeah.
Definitely. Well, Azrael's kind of like Punisher Batman. Azrael was like after Bane broke Batman's back, he takes over for him, and he's got like way more like fucking sweet looking shit on his armor. He looks fucking awesome, but he's also like an asshole and like kind of a supervillain almost. And there's a comic where like he takes over everything, and Batman is just like a man in a fucking like jar with like his spine, like it's just literally Bruce Wayne's head and like a metallic spine, and he's just like telling Azrael like you should stop being a dick, and Azrael's like no, I rule Gotham.
That's
some of my favorite
things. I've been getting into lore again. I want to do 40k lore, but I've been watching some normie TV with my girlfriend. I watched The Boys, and it was terrible. It was just the worst. I don't recommend it. It sucks. then I watched House of the Dragon. I was kind of getting into like Game of Thrones lore a little bit again, but I'm like, first of all, I don't want to talk about like the hip new fucking show. And I haven't read anything since I read the Game of Thrones shit. And I feel like fucking Warhammer will hit way better, so I want to do some of that content. I want to do a Warhammer stream. I got some hot takes on Warhammer. I got some predictions on how the future will go in the universe. I'm gonna get that shit out.
Hell yeah.
Jeez.
Well, that segues right into what we were going to talk about with Israel.
Does it though? Okay, so Israel was attacked by a bunch of like Hamas forces, a bunch of random guys essentially who just like went around killing people. Lots of crazy videos came out of that, and lots of spurious claims of like, they always have like the babies being killed every time. It's being like pulled out of the incubator and thrown on the fucking ground, or the throat slit, or they're being stomped on, or you always hear this crap every time they want to like drum up a new war. Same thing with Iran. They wouldn't be mentioning Iran in connection with this unless it was total fucking nonsense. And that's kind of my position on it right now. What's up, Flame? We're live right now. Hey, guy.
What, we're live?
Hell yeah, we're live. Are you kidding me?
Where are we going?
What? We're talking about the Israel situation right now. I had predicted, basically, everybody was coming in here and fucking saying that it's over for Israel now. And I had to tell everybody, like, it's not quite that simple. What? Like, we've seen this happen before. This is something that's occurred many times in the past.
Yeah, I mean, like, even though, like, that Hamas has put in lately is pretty interesting. But I don't think because look at the way Israel is responding. They do the same thing every time. They just nuke the fuck out of Gaza Strip.
It's not just Israel though. Look at it like 9/11. Look at it like that. Now
you have like an attack that's imminent, and its intelligence knows that, and they basically stand down for it. You have the stories of Rumsfeld telling NORAD to stand down and shit like that, knowing that they're going to gain politically because of the situation. Now, a lot of people look at the situation. They look at Netanyahu and they're like, well, he looks weak for letting this happen. But if you think back to 9/11, do you think George Bush, he wasn't exactly looked at as weak after 9/11. In fact, come on, Mike, fix that.
No, he responded pretty well.
His approval went through the goddamn roof. And he immediately looked like the baddest motherfucker on earth because he was just dropping bombs on people.
Well, that's the thing, like, the way the media has portrayed it, Netanyahu's not really to blame or to be looked weak at, because, like, they've already come up with that, the story that it was Iran, it was in cahoots with Hamas, somehow gaining information about how to get past the Iron Dome.
Yeah.
So that's the key thing right there, is, like, for years, the Iron Dome has been the state-of-the-art missile defense, to the point that, like, America has their own version. They don't call it that. But, like, Ukraine has been, honestly trying to get Israel to give it to them. But, like, Israel has relations with Russia, and that would look bad if Israel gave that to Ukraine. So, like, they never gave that shit up.
I forget the name they use for, like, Ukraine being that whole defense situation they have against Russia for the European Union. I don't remember the name of it, but that's, like, what these shitty states like Ukraine exist for, as proxies between, like, the EU and Russia, essentially.
Yeah, pretty much. That's how they've been used, like, during the Cold War. So, like, we're just seeing that shit ramp up in modern times. It's the same exact shit. There's talks that Russia was behind giving Iran the ability to get past the Iron Dome. That's the rumor. So, like, at this point, like, it seems like it's very strategic, because Russia helps Iran. Iran helps, was it Hezbollah? Or no, was it Hamas?
You can't even tell anymore, because there's no ideological reason for any of it, except Iran is the bad guys.
But get this, I'm not even done. Because by doing that, Russia is taking away U.S. funding from Ukraine. There's no money going to Ukraine right now because the Speaker of the House just got outed. Now, that's a power grab. I think Donald Trump is behind that. Like, not really Donald Trump, per se, like, but, like, the Republicans are trying to be, like, the Democrats right now.
Well, huh? I don't know what the fuck you're trying to say.
This is a whole manifesto right now. I just want you to know, you need to publish shit. Just explain to me, like, your politics for the past, like, 2 years, bro. Like, that was, it was a lot. Go on, man.
What I'm saying is, like, there's no money going to Ukraine, so that's going to damage their war effort. With no speaker in the House right now, McCarthy just got outed. So, like, there's no speaker in the House to address any payments to Ukraine. So, Ukraine.
Who gives a shit?
It's worth talking about why he got booted. I mean, it's not that.
Counterpoint to all this crap. Who gives a fuck?
Well, I mean, if you want to go conspiracy route, dude, like, that's one right there. Like, so Ukraine's about to get fucked.
Everybody's been saying Ukraine's gonna get fucked. They'll be fine.
My big conspiracy theory is they're already getting fucked, and our media is just lying constantly to us that it's not as bad as it is.
Like, I don't want to say it's like they're doing great over there, but I think the stalemate has been, like, is pretty clear.
They're on a serious offensive lately.
I think a lot more people died than they're saying now. Yeah, but probably. Like, I think that's like the main lie they're telling.
Yeah.
And a ton fewer Russians than they're saying.
So like they so basically if that's correct that Putin like whacks a shit ton of birds with one stone by doing that, if it's true.
Maybe. Yeah. I don't know. That is truly some 4D chess that I will have to meditate on before coming to an immediate conclusion.
Dude, when I was like realizing that shit, I was like, holy fuck, dude. Because I'm over here listening to like news on the radio, and then like I'm like putting the pieces together and shit. And I've heard other people's takes on the internet as well.
I don't think so, that's like, a bad take really, but the thing is, like, I think this is a very simple situation. I think the U.S. government paid a bunch of jerk-offs in the Middle East to act a fool for the past 100 years. For our benefit.
Are you saying Hamas?
Yeah, probably. Here's the other thing. Dude, is like, I don't believe when they're like, this one group did this. I don't believe that. I think there are individual cells within groups that are paid to act as stupid as possible for the benefit of the West.
Other thing is, Hamas was aligned with Israel against the PLO for the longest time. And then, like, the PLO got eliminated, you know.
Who's the PLO?
The old fucking Palestinian terrorist organization.
I forgot that shit ever happened.
Yeah, they were, like, aligned with, like, communists, and, like, they were way, like, super hardcore. Yeah, like, the Hamas, like, was against them, and Israel was on their, like, they sided with them, they backed them. Yeah, like this is exact, I mean, it's so close to what happened with the Mujahideen and, like, Al-Qaeda. You give them a bunch of weapons to go fight your enemy, they fight your enemy, they beat your enemy, then they become your enemy. That's literally what happened with Hamas. Yeah. Like, Hamas beat the PLO, and now Hamas is the fucking PLO, as far as Israel's concerned.
So this could be, like, the Western influence blowback for doing that. Yeah, that old cliche.
Here's the thing, is like, I was talking to someone earlier who was like, we've wanted to invade Iran for the past 10 years, but it's like, no, we've wanted to invade Iran since the last time we fucking staged a coup in their country and installed a fucking dictator and they had to overthrow him. Like, we've been doing this.
Yeah. Straight up.
So let's go to Exhibit A on my reasons why this is bullshit. This is a video that was posted by Hamas on their social media just a few days before the attack. So let's check out what what Mossad intentionally ignored here. Let's check it out, dude. Let's watch this. I can see it when you laugh at this is exactly as it was, untouched, unedited.
Where can I see this?
In the stream, you fucking goofface. In Discord, it's there, bro. I drink piss.
Yeah! They posted that a day before the fucking invasion.
I don't know if it was the day before or what the fuck, but it was just before.
Wow.
So everybody knows
that's what I call PR.
Yeah, everybody knows that Islamic jihadists love Limp Bizkit. And dude, fucking Fred, I actually have a list of Fred Durst facts. Let me break one out right now for you guys live. Here we go. In 2015, Durst stated his interest in obtaining a Russian passport and spending half of the year in Crimea. He wrote a letter in which he stated that Vladimir Putin is a great guy with clear moral principles and a nice person. Following that, Durst was banned by the Security Service of Ukraine from entering Ukraine for 5 years in the interests of guaranteeing security of the country.
Yo, I think this is a 4D meta, like, psychological bullshit going on right here. Like, that is so obscure about Frank Durst that happened to him, and then, like, that they're not getting any more funding, and all the money from the United States is going to Fred Durst.
Amazing.
Dog, fix your mic. For the love of God, keep coming in. Every time you come in, it sounds like assholes. Let me go over some other Fred Durst facts before we go on with this. So, Davis and Durst wrote the lyrics for All in the Family, which featured the two... So it's the lead singer of Korn and Limp Bizkit, which featured the two vocalists trading insults. Davis and Durst would often offer suggestions for each other's lyrics. A lyric written by Durst as "Tootin' on your bagpipe" was changed to "Fagpipes" by Davis, who stated, "I helped your bag on me better."
They had like a fake beef, like a wrestling beef.
Who?
Right?
Those two? I'm Biscuit? Pretty sure they've never beefed in history, and they've only made a shitload.
Oh no, Limp Bizkit and Korn beef, dude. Yeah, if you listen to fucking
That's why
listen to the lyrics on a fucking what is that album called? Follow the Leader.
Well, it's definitely pro wrestling, man.
There's Follow the Leader. There's a whole like Limp Bizkit diss track on that shit. Anyway. Yeah, actually.
Back to gay ass is one of the worst.
One of the worst diss tracks I've ever heard in my life, but it's great. It's like a time capsule.
Back to the videos, dog. That's the Hamas fighters appear to paraglide across the border and released footage to go attack Israeli citizens. Now, look at this dude. Look at this dude. Now, it does look awesome. I'll give them that. But I'm pretty sure Mossad could see these guys coming from a mile away.
Paragliders.
Am I wrong?
It was so
audacious. V65.
Fix your mic, you goddamn goof.
Me?
No. Yeah, so... Dude, this is the most staged crap I've ever seen in my life. Anybody?
You don't think the gyrocopter... Their little gyrocopters. That was a cool idea.
I don't think the guy.
Yeah, obviously you never played Rust, dude. Obviously you never played Rust because dude,
I've never played Fortnite. I've never had to paraglide into the fucking battlefield.
Dude, I stand corrected. We're talking about the same thing. Like the Limp Bizkit beef I'm thinking about is the song "All in the Family."
Yeah, yeah,
that you're talking about.
So. Here we go. I have some news from the Times of Israel here. I'm getting it right from the horse's mouth. Egypt intelligence official says Israel ignored repeated warnings of something big. Right from Egypt intelligence.
Dude, all right.
So they were saying that they were too busy cracking down in the West Bank. Netanyahu said they were too busy cracking down in the West Bank to possibly worry about the situation that he was being directly warned about.
Wow.
He stood down. It's just like 9/11. It's the same thing.
But like that doesn't explain the Iron Dome thing, because like how did they get past that? Because like they like I don't know if the Iron Dome is going to shoot them with the gyrocopters now, but like the missiles they shot are supposed to be taken out.
Yeah, no, actually, I have some video I want to show of it in action. The Iron Dome is pretty cool, but it seems to me that like there must have been orders to like, dude,
stand down.
I wouldn't be surprised if in the next few days we got news that there was like a War Games thing happening on that day when it occurred. You know what I mean?
I mean, it could go either way, but I feel you, though. It just seems like the story we keep getting told, which is like, you know, oh, this terrorist attack happened, we couldn't have done anything about it, but, you know, in reality, they could have done a lot of things about it.
So, U.S. State Department diplomats warned not to call for ceasefire, calm, or an end to violence.
Yeah.
What the
fuck? Well, they just were told not to say anything about this, except for that Israel, you know, save Israel.
No, exactly. But that's the thing. You don't want to say anything that can be misconstrued as being on the side of Palestine. Let's be clear about this. Like, they want this because it gives them an opportunity. Joe Biden went on stage. I wish I got this video together. I didn't even think to. And he said, this gives us... Dude. He says something along the lines of like, this gives us an opportunity to deal with the problem once and for all. And like, what he means is go and bulldoze all that fucking shit.
And that's supposed to happen tonight, by the way.
And, but the funny thing is, like, what he said was basically, we are ready for the final solution.
Yeah.
Like, that's Jesus what I got out of it. Right. That's what I got out of it.
Boomers will, like, shit on you for not
supporting. But Trump is going even harder than Joe Biden. It's become like China. It's become like the China shit, where it's like Trump is just like, Joe Biden's controlled by the Palestinians. He gave money to the Palestinians. I'm going to go in and bomb the shit out of the guys. I would, if I was president, I'd send my troops right into Gaza.
Well, this is why I immediately shadowed everybody who came and while it was happening was like, it's over for Israel. They're getting wiped off the map. It's like, specifically, that might as well be the neocon argument. You might as well be Donald Rumsfeld making that argument, because it's exactly the excuse they need to go bulldoze everything and invade Iran. It's exactly the excuse.
I'm legit concerned that, like, Gaza's basically not going to exist after this.
Yeah.
Like, I think that's a real thing that could happen.
I don't want to say I'm concerned about that. I literally don't care about any of these people. But, that is probably what's going to happen, is this is leading to bulldozing the whole strip.
What we're about to watch is a sanctioned genocide of a people, and we're all going to, watch it happen.
There will always be reasons that it's not a genocide. At the end of the day, they do want the land, and they don't give a fuck. They don't need to kill the people necessarily. They need to break the people and make them outsiders and strangers forever, or just leave.
They're also ethnically the same as the people of Jordan, so like they're still going to be Palestinians in Jordan. Like they're the same.
Well, and I don't want to sit here and make excuses for it. My point is, like, it essentially is going to be a genocide, but like it's just that the definition of genocide is so flimsy. Like, they'll never have to admit that shit.
No,
they're just going to call it war right now.
They can't call it war. If they called it war, I can't figure this out anymore. Israel. I'm talking about the U.S. What are we talking about here? I don't think the U.S. calls it war yet. If you called it war, you'd have to start putting bills in front of Congress and shit.
No. We are not going to war. Israel's at war.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. For sure.
Yeah. That's what they said. Like, they're declaring war on Hamas.
They don't even, to call it war would be almost to give it too much dignity. The Israelis call the Palestinians animals. So it's like going to war with cows to them.
They consider any non-Jews, right? Like the real religious ones.
I don't know exactly how, like, your average person in Israel feels about that. You know, it's essentially what I get from regular Jews is a unwavering loyalty to Israel, which I guess, and I can sympathize with on one level, because if my people were in charge of Israel, I'd probably support them too. That said, Israel is responsible for more heinous crimes than any other country on earth right now, hands down. So absolutely, it is what it is. Yeah. I don't want to sit here and, like, I don't want to denigrate whole groups of people, because that's not my day-to-day life. In fact, in my day-to-day life, I don't know any Jews or Arabs, like, at all. So,
I know really, Maude.
No, this isn't. Like, I'm not trying to virtue signal. What I'm saying is, like, it is a total, like, lack of investment. And to me, it seems like having an opinion on Middle Eastern politics is basically the most Semitic thing you can do. I literally don't care. I'm offended by the fact that they insist that I care, or I'm basically a criminal.
Yeah, and they want to send fucking money over there. That's my fucking problem with it.
I don't even give a shit about that at the end of the day. We're sending money everywhere. It's all fake. Who cares?
I'll try to tread lightly on this, but, like, it's very interesting to me that some of the loudest voices against Israel are from Jews. That is interesting to me.
It depends who you're referring to here. I think I can see that on a couple levels. On one level, it's a total fucking grift.
The Orthodox Jewish community.
There's that. But that is a very small percentage.
And like Judith Butler.
Yeah, they were the minority.
And like, what's the guy? Norm Finkelstein. Norm Finkelstein keeps getting.
Yeah, Norm Finkelstein's a good one. Yeah.
It becomes an internal struggle within, like, amongst Jews. And that also reflects the fact that, like, Palestinian, like, it's no hate on Jews for that. It's just the fact that, like, Palestinians and, like, yeah, Palestinians don't have a voice at all. Like no one gives a fuck what they think about anything. So it becomes just like the Jews who are against what other Jews are doing and the Jews who are for what other Jews are doing. And it's just basically like,
I think as a Jew, I can't see why you wouldn't support Israel unless you are like autistic about scripture and you're like, no, that's not how this happens. Yeah. And that is how it is in the Jewish community.
A lot of Jews are social, like far left, like left wing anti-colonialists and all that.
Well, I'm with it. I hate it.
There's
different
groups. You got like the thing is that like you have the religious Jews and then you have what you said, the atheistic Jews.
Yeah, right. The secular.
But like they come together on this fucking ethnostate thing.
Well, that's every atheistic Jew I've ever met. But, a lot of people I liked, all of them would defend Israel. Every single one of them. I've never met a Jew in my life who wouldn't. And I Orthodox understand Jews. That.
The Orthodox Jews don't, like you said, this isn't how it's supposed to happen, because, you know, like, they don't believe that the founding of the way Israel was founded isn't authentic to what the scripture says. But they're the minority and they're the only ones that like clash. They can't do much because they don't have no power in the Jewish sphere, so like they get ignored. So they're the Palestinians.
Well, their claim is unserious. Nobody cares about their interpretation of scripture. That will never, ever, ever come into
which one play. The Orthodox.
Yeah, that's not part of that's not part of the argument, and it never will be. Yeah, I don't know. I think the key is here is just to get ready for Gaza to get steamrolled because it is reality. Love it or hate it.
I think like 50% of Gaza is wiped out. Like I'm ready.
Let me go through some of this content I have here, dude. I got
let's go.
So
let's see.
Supposedly Israel is moving to full offense. Gaza will never go back to what it once was. Is a quote. From a defense minister. So they're gearing up for a ground offensive. Now, they're saying the ground invasion of Gaza is imminent, and I've actually seen flyers from Gaza where they're giving them out, telling people to get the hell out. Like, we're basically going to wreck this shit. You get away, as far away as you can. And they're not making it easy because it is just like an open-air concentration camp.
Because it's
a ghetto, like where they shove the Palestinians into. Yeah,
like they're completely surrounded. I'm pretty sure, like they had Navy forces on the fucking water too. So like they're completely surrounded. Like this is gonna be one hell of a siege. Do you even think they're gonna put up a defense?
Who?
Like a really good defense?
Literally
to Hamas?
Who? No. We've seen what Hamas is. Hamas is a bunch of random fucking guys.
Yeah, we
saw them. And I bet half of them are dead already, at least. Yeah. They've been killing these guys.
Yeah, dude. Or what?
I don't know. I mean, maybe some of them have legit skills and they're still out there.
If Hezbollah gets involved, I think
the legit skills thing, I don't like maybe, who knows, but the thing is like the legit skills thing is negated by how fucking haphazard the invasion was. There's not even a force to fight. It was a bunch of random people. There's not this is a totally, what do they call this? Asymmetrical warfare, right? Where it's all one side here. That's what this is. Hamas has nothing really, dude.
Yeah, they had to work in lone cells because, like, they parachuted in, like, deep into Israel. So, like, there are probably some motherfuckers operating in some fucking town somewhere that they haven't been killed yet. But like these
I gotta have men inside the IDF.
Well, the thing is, there. I don't think this shit is as capable as you dream it. I think the only place where this shit is like affluent, Hamas or any of this jihadi cell bullshit, the only place that it thrives or is affluent is where the West funds it.
Yeah, I forgot. Yeah, because like that makes sense because they funded it in like fucking Bosnia during the Yugoslav war.
Now, you got to think like it is a ghetto. This is basically an open air prison. So in order to get arms and to be able to create your own whatever the fuck you're, I don't know what the fuck they can make themselves, but it's all shit that's smuggled in. So that's where Iran comes into play, and I'm sure there is some validity there. But like, who aren't like the U.S. is sending guns everywhere? It's not like fucking dealing guns is a fucking crime. And I don't know what the fuck's a crime internationally, but I'll tell you what, U.S. is fucking guilty of all of them. So whatever, dude. So how could they have the arsenal that could rival Israel or any of Israel's allies when they're just smuggling shit in?
The Israeli settlements are considered to be illegal by the U.S.
The UN? By the U.S.
The UN doesn't do shit.
We don't send any funding to the settlements. We deliberately we've tried to reduce them from doing the settlements. When I say we, I mean literally the federal government. I don't mean the Trump administration. I don't mean Jared Kushner's family. I don't mean any of the people that are in power. I'm saying like literally George Bush Sr. tried to suppress that, and he tried to reduce the settlements.
Of that as legitimate. I think that's another case. We talked about a few cases of it already. Stop with the ICE, Jesus Christ! ICE, stop with the ICE. It's fucking. Where the fuck? Where was I going with any of this fucking bullshit?
You don't agree with that Bush.
Yeah, there is, we see all the time the government and, you know, the, I don't know, academia, social circles, whatever the fuck. Man, I'm trying so hard to grasp what I was just talking about. So they don't want to overstep their bounds. They don't want to overreach things and immediately piss everybody off. I think that's something we're seeing with the left. That's why you have a trans rally, and now these people are talking about how they support Palestine. And it's like, okay, go to Palestine. It's the obvious argument. But these are cases of the government pushing things too far, where they have to reel it in a little bit. It's the same thing with Israel. Israel will have their greater Israel, but the government, all they can do is be like, can we just slow it down here a little? And Israel will be like, no.
Well, I think it's also we're desensitized. How surprised were you when they started bombing the fuck out of them? Bombing the fuck out of them the next day? How many times have they done that?
That's I was assuming they were doing that every day anyway. I don't know.
Yeah.
It's getting reported now.
I literally did have the idea that every once in a while they'll go at it. Because that's why they got the Iron Dome. They're always trying to shoot this shit into the fucking Israel.
While we're talking about that, let's check out a video of that. New York Post.
Is that it?
Rockets, dog. This isn't the video. They go to the next one. It's good.
This is the Iron Dome.
Right here.
Gotta get some Iron Dome from a Jewish baddie.
Incoming rockets.
Oh shit. Wow.
Wow. It's basically just launching missiles to intercept them.
Yeah. But it's pretty cool how accurate and how ready it is.
I wonder if they launched a whole fuckload of them,
That's supposedly what they did. They launched so fucking many that it couldn't keep up with them, allegedly. Which sounds like a great excuse for just having NORAD stand the fuck down on 9/11. Am I wrong?
There was this conspiracy theorist who was a weird communist, basically, fuck, I'm forgetting what it, damn. But he advocated for like Space Force because he thought that not Space Force, Star Wars, the Reagan Star Wars program.
Yeah.
Because he thought that was like our best defense against nuclear war, and he like kept running for president to try to propose that we should like have missile defense systems in place to prevent us from like getting nuked and all this shit.
I think that's a big part of what Space Force is to intercept fucking like nuclear warheads and shit like that. I think that's a big part of it. That's why they want space lasers.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, space lasers and shit like that. Lasers. You know, the threat of nuclear war. Like, some people think like this might be like the precursor because
in Fallout.
I was just thinking about that too. The second there, because I was just like, isn't that weird? You know, in the game, the nukes fall in 2077.
And, it's in October, yeah.
Yeah, and it's also like before the bombs dropped, there was like a terrorist attack on Israel that did involve a nuke, so Israel got fucking nuked in Fallout. So
I'm less of a Fallout Israel guy, and I'm more of a Warhammer Israel guy.
Fallout Israel.
Warhammer Israel.
Fallout New Tel Aviv.
Wait, what's the relevance of 2077?
2077 was the date where in the Fallout universe that nuclear Armageddon happened.
Right, I get that. But you were saying that's connected to this. What's happening now?
I mean, it's kind of like uncanny because, like in the lore of Fallout, like a couple of years before 2077, there was like a terrorist attack on Israel that a nuclear bomb did end up going off in Israel. So, like, yeah. So, like that.
Real life will never be as cool as video games. Fucking... Gamers, just accept it.
Yeah.
Whatever happens is going to be the lamest shit possible. Just bet on that.
I was about to say, like, I highly doubt, like, somebody... super mutant. I mean, unless, like, somebody gave them a fucking Hamas something, we don't know. So, hopefully nobody gave them shit.
What do you mean, like, ketamine?
That's kind of the thing. They nuked Israel. They nuked like they are in Israel. So it's
yeah,
like if they, nuke
they can't
Israel,
do that. All talk of nukes is nonsense in this particular situation. Now, I don't think it's inconceivable that this situation could set off a chain reaction of situations that could lead to someone using nukes. But I also wouldn't bet on that. They literally want to turn it the ice, dude. Stop doing that shit. They literally want to turn that shit into a fucking parking lot with, like, McDonald's and shit, dude. That's what they want.
This goes back to the project of the New American Century. You know, the neocon agenda. They said, we need a new Pearl Harbor to justify invading Syria, Libya, Iraq, Iran.
Well, this was a bunch of fucking Mossad and neocon people being like, we need a new 9/11. But this time, in Israel, with paragliders. we need a paraglider flying into the fucking trade center, dude. That's what we need.
Like, I don't know if this was a false flag, but it might have just been inevitable that they were going to do some shit. But it might have been.
To like the revolution will not be televised, brother. If this was some real grassroots shit, they wouldn't even tell you about it. They're only telling you because they need your reaction. Like, they did this
I
to get a
if
reaction.
People were swooping up like girls in Israel and just rapping them. I think we're gonna know if that's happening.
Here a take I have. What if they're just like us, with the same exact internet influence? So they put that video out, and they barely got any views on it until after the shit happened. And
no, Mossad and CIA exist. Is the part you're forgetting?
No, but they posted it on like my account instead of your account. And nobody watches my account because
But the CIA does watch your account.
Oh, damn.
That's what you... No, but, like, to some degree, like, dude, if Twitter knows who the fuck you are, like, it knows who I am. If I go and make a Twitter account, that shit will be gone within a week without me ever posting anything that fucking mattered, because it knows who the fuck I am. If you are Hamas, Twitter knows who the fuck you are. They know you just made a fucking official Hamas account. They fucking know. And they just told the CIA. The CIA told Mossad. Mossad told the reptilians. The reptilians told the Demiurge. And the shit is over.
The Demiurge.
Oh, fuck.
They know. You can always count on that. What else there? So the Raim Music Festival massacre. They're ruining music festivals for us.
Yo, and this is
dude, that's why you guys show up at the hippie festival with your gat.
Strapped. Yeah, that's
definitely. Yeah, right. Yeah.
Festival was to protest Israel. Like, that's what's really so dark to me. Yeah, it was supposed to be protesting, like, fucking... the Israelis don't like their prime minister. Like, he's, like, they consider him, like, a fascist.
It says Sukkot gathering. What the fuck is Sukkot? Is that some Jewish holiday, though?
It's a peace gathering.
Well,
peace.
That's peace? That's what that is? Let me double check.
Yeah.
It's a holiday. It's a holiday.
Yom Kippur. It was a Yom Kippur celebration.
So here's the thing. Once you're doing like a Jewish holiday celebration, you're no longer doing a, like, you know, a protest.
You're no longer what?
You're no longer protesting Israel.
You're doing a music festival?
Well, they were celebrating a Jewish holiday.
Well, Yom Kippur. It's a Jewish protest within Israel.
I hear you, but when you call it the Supernova Sukkot Gathering, you have made this a Jewish festival full of degenerates. How can this not be? Like, I don't know what I'm trying to say here exactly. My point is, like, these weren't people who were specifically there to protest Israel. They were there to do drugs on a Jewish holiday.
Well, yeah, those are the people that protest Israel in Israel.
I guess, but that's kind of my point, is that all these people protesting Israel are full of fucking shit. Yeah. They don't know what they're talking about.
Yeah, no, I mean, they're like students.
They're basically and, like, the trans rally talking about supporting Palestine, but it's like, try doing that right on the fucking Gaza border.
Right.
Might have been stupid, actually, to do that. You know what I mean? Yeah. I'm just saying, like, I don't know. Look, dude, I'm not trying to blame them. But I'm saying it was a bad idea. Shouldn't have been on the fucking, right on the border of Gaza. Great move.
They should have been in the Gaza Strip.
This is how they, like... I don't know. There's a lot to be said about it, but like the way that they go about trying to create peaceful relations with Palestinians is like directly going into their communities and saying like, we're all one, we're all together. Like, let's like, we might have some cultural truth, but, you know, and we
all the shit out of them.
And then you're basically creating like the ultimate target. Like,
yeah,
you're
that's what I'm saying. Like, we could have the gathering of the Juggalos right on the Gaza border, and we could be like, "Yeah, whoop whoop, homies." It's like, but if are we expecting them to whoop back? They're not for the fucking stream. Just for your ass. Just roll with me here. Do we not expect them to whoop whoop back? Like, they won't. They won't. It's a bad plan. God damn
it! It didn't work. This festival did not work. I think we can objectively say that the peace festival did not succeed.
Well, it never. That's the lesson of Vietnam, and that's the failing of the hippies. And I do still believe in ideas like communes, and I'm into all the festivals, and I'm into shit like that. What the fuck is Polak doing, dude? I'm just gonna ban this guy for the fucking evening. Most retarded shit I've ever seen in my life. What the fuck is happening?
He keeps coming in and out.
Hippies is no one ever like paraglided into a hippie festival and just started like committing atrocities like at Woodstock.
They might have learned their lesson if that happened. That didn't happen to Woodstock 99 when Fred Durst played the break stuff.
And that's literally who Woodstock 99 is. Fred Durst came in with a paraglider and started raping women.
Do you guys think there were more rapes at the Rian Music Festival Massacre or at Woodstock 99?
Definitely more at the...
I think at Woodstock. There's probably more just in one porta potty at Woodstock 99.
That's true.
Yeah, I'm going to go for third world catastrophe over... televised 90s event.
I have some facts about that. I have to pull them up. Hold up, let me find my quick facts. Woodstock was
about Hamas attacking Woodstock 99.
Woodstock was tarnished by violent behavior from the crowd, much of which occurred during and after the performance of Break Stuff, including fans tearing plywood from the walls during the song. Several sexual assaults were reported in the aftermath of the concert. So there's that.
That's so
wait. What's worse? What's worse? Fucking.
It's every major.
Fred Durst causing like 300 fucking rapes in one porta potty, or signing Puddle of Mud. Blow the way, smack my ass.
Everything's so blurry.
Everyone's so gay. Yeah. Dude.
Wasn't it like Korn came on, and like other than Limp Bizkit Break Stuff, of course, and Korn came on and fucking like everybody started just like ripping the fucking place apart. Like that whole thing was bound to be fucked.
You got a bunch of, really like, matter, dude,
it was 99.
They could have brought out Blind Melon and played No Rain for 6 hours. They still would have fucking tore that place in half and raped all the women. It was bound to happen. Yeah. 90s were a fucked up place. I was glad I was there. I'm glad. So during a 2001 tour of Australia at the Big Day Out Festival in Sydney, fans rushed the stage in the mosh pit at a Limp Bizkit show, and teenager Jessica Michalik died of asphyxiation. Rest in peace.
They just fucking choked her ass to death on stage, huh? This is live at the Limp Bizkit concert.
Yeah, they hung her on stage because her skirt was too fucking short, so they hung her on stage.
New Metal is a terrorist organization.
Yeah. So, but here's the thing.
Limp Bizkit specifically, apparently.
No,
like,
there was a big scandal. Big scandal in the Islamic world on February of 2005 when a sex tape featuring Durst was released on the internet. Durst filed a $70 million lawsuit against 10 websites that posted the video. But I bet you can find it right now if you want to jerk off to it. Haram. Haram.
How could you do somebody like that?
So new metal is terrorist music the meme?
Yeah, but they're also on the FBI gang list because in 2012, Durst appeared on the Insane Clown Posse cover album Smothered, Covered, and Chunked on a cover of AMG's Bitch Better Have My Money. So he's also a juggalo, which makes him an official gang member.
Largest gang in America.
In 1999, Marilyn Manson insulted Limp Bizkit and their fans, calling them illiterate apes that beat your ass in high school for being a fag, and now sell you tuneless testosterone anthems of misogyny and pretend to be outsiders. I don't know. I don't want to follow that up with anything. But it's
that was Charles Manson's take.
Yeah.
Fred Durst was saying Charles Manson was a fag.
So, they're...
That's what Frank Durst said about Charles Manson.
A lot of people don't know that their name wasn't always going to be Limp Bizkit. Other names were considered, including Gimp Disco, Bitch Piglet, Split Dick Slit, and Blood Fart.
There's no way that's real. Why were all of the names rhyming with Limp Bizkit?
Literally, because Led Zeppelin, Def Leppard. That's what he was doing. I promise you. I've done this as a high school kid. He was doing a Led Zeppelin thing. Yeah, Split Dick Slit is the fucking funniest shit I ever heard in my fucking life. If they were called Split Dick Slit, I'd be bopping that shit still to this day. Promise you that, dude.
There we go. Internet was.
Hey, dude.
Well, your internet was fucking sending you through a time warp. Like, what the fuck?
It was like, fuck, I had to go like restart the fucking modem and everything.
So the band was allowed to interact directly with its fans on a website established by Dyke 99.
Mm. Yeah. Love Dyke 99.
Yeah. It's my favorite Twitter poster. Oh, shit, dude. Fred Durst. That's fucking funny as hell.
Fred Durst's a wild dude. Durst. Like, he's like, he hasn't done anything outrageous himself, but like, except fuck Christina Aguilera.
No, look, he did some crazy shit. He made a fucking fairly like respectable movie where John Travolta plays a complete retard. He plays an actual retarded guy. Fanatic? The Fanatic, I believe. I think it's The Fanatic.
Yeah. Never go for a retard.
Yeah. Is that one of the schizophrenic? Part of the schizophrenic series? Of
the quadrilogy. Yeah, most definitely. Quadrussy, as Pollock would say.
Harry Russo, played by Fred Durst.
While we're talking about schizophrenic, why don't we check in? Let's have a video call with Ashley and see what the fuck she's doing. Ashley Hatch, you're online. Let's see.
She's alive.
Yeah, dude.
What are you doing? Stop hurting my vagina! I don't like it. It feels like I'm giving birth to a baby. It hurts. Stop! Leave me alone! I'm gonna press charges on you. I'm going to. I'm gonna sue you, and I'm gonna put you in jail, and I'm gonna press charges on you.
Thanks, Ashley. I'm glad you're doing well.
Damn, look at the actual, like, normally her unhingedness is, like, anger and, like, malice. She's in, like, fear and, like, despair.
Well, I'll tell you,
like,
what's
it's
going
not
on
just,
here.
Like, actual despair, objective despair.
Here's the thing. For Ashley, she doesn't look that bad. There's no holes in her face. There's places where there were holes where it healed up. There's some nasty shitlocks she's got growing in her fucking hair. It's whack, but she looks pretty good for Ashley. So this is Ashley just after escaping the group home. Could wind up anywhere. You never know where she'll be next. Could be at your doorstep.
Do you think she masturbated until it hurt and then blamed the CIA for it?
No, she was probably raped in the group home, to be honest, and then she's fucking having flashbacks of it.
Pretty sure this is like rage at her own libido.
Well, it's more complicated than that. Here's the thing. She thinks she's in the wrong body. You could say it's trans, but it's more metaphysical than that. Mm-hmm. She does believe she is a man, and she is in the wrong, disgusting body, and she believes that other people are using her body to hurt her.
That would make sense with some MKUltra.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck it is, and there's no time to with the ice. What the fuck, dude? The Chewing Ice podcast.
Here's the thing, like, if she was an MKUltra sex slave, I feel like they would keep her in better shape.
Well, the Aryan Brotherhood was in charge of her.
Was what?
She says, the Aryan Brotherhood were her keepers.
Oh. Well, yeah. That's not the CIA, but that's like tangential.
Yeah, it's like third level. It's like D-tier CIA.
D-tier?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the bottom of the card, brother.
I
think I would like give her some makeup and like kind of fix some of that stuff going on over there.
What's what Doro was trying to do, brother?
Doro sent her a Slipknot shirt and then she disappeared off the face of the earth. I don't know if the two things
maybe
are related.
Maybe we'll see it on one of these videos.
We've looked for a year and a half, two years.
We think she was gone from the house by the time the shirt would have gotten there.
Damn.
Is what we think. You never know, dude.
Dude, so, like, that's a good idea that you said there. You should do, like, a segment or a video about ranking organizations by tiers. So, like, CIA is...
Oh, yeah, the tier list.
That is pretty funny. Like, the Fed tier list?
The gay op tier list.
Yeah, the Fed tier list, yeah. And then we put criminal organizations and where they fall in.
I was just talking to Jack about doing some sort of tier list.
The post office is like...
We were going to do like horror movie tier
list. The post office
is
F tier.
Yeah, the post
office. DMV F tier because of the weight.
The Grateful Dead show is like E tier.
Yeah.
Oh, hell yeah, dude. Fantastic.
Sounds good. All
right. I guess we're kind
of... live.
Huh?
I'm glad she's alive.
Yeah, well, me too. Do you know who's not alive? Mama JF. So let's touch back on that little milieu. And we talked about it last week, and I am very interested in the whole situation. JF is coming off as autistic and guilty as possible. I wouldn't put it past JF to just be that autistic and come off that way. And I wouldn't put it past Mama JF to being such a free spirit that she wanted to go live in a life of adventure in the public park. So... the only issue I really have is that there are kids involved. That's the biggest thing. Second thing is that nobody knew she was gone for 3 months, and it had to be like the baby doctor, the doctor of the babies. They do have kids. I was wrong about that last week. There's two kids. So. Yeah, I don't know who it was, but someone called about an appointment for the kids, and that's when they found out she hasn't been there, and they called the authorities about it. Now it's a full-on investigation, and JF is coming off as guilty as fucking possible.
That's crazy.
Yeah, now the reason...
I hope
children as, like, a, like, Chad red pill move, as, like, a sign of, like, yeah, I won because I have the children.
Yeah.
And so I have defeated the incel.
Yes.
And then you just literally don't give a fuck about these kids at all.
Well, that's the thing is, like, I think me and Senor were talking about this, the relationship between a retarded person and, like the Down syndrome kid and their mom. Like, they are have, like, an inseparable bond. You know what I'm talking about? No, I gotta think it's the same with the retarded mom and the normal kid.
Yep.
Right? So
yeah, because they're like soul bonded. They're like the same.
Yeah. So
soul bonding.
So I just don't believe that she would just leave the kids without a trace for 3 fucking months. I don't buy any of that. Now the thing is, as guilty as JF seems, I don't want to throw him like under the bus just yet because there is another suspect. And we've talked about this before. Other streams have talked about this. I watched fucking the Kiwi Farm stream and I watched Josh get it all fucking wrong because he didn't have the context right. We have the context, dude. And we have a suspect, mind you. Let's check out this video, boys and girls. One way or the other.
Is it not?
Paris is lovely and Nice sure is nice.
There she is. There's a girl, Mama JF. Another golden one, lost from the world. Gone too soon. Always remember Mama JF.
That being said, it's a cheese that I really love.
Is this the wrong one?
The original orange cheddar.
Let's just watch it.
Now people are saying, Jeff, why don't you share with Mama JF? Well, do you want some?
No, because we went to his mother house and after I drank so much this morning and then I feel like, oh my god.
This is the face of a man who would kill his wife.
That is the dark triad right there in its completion.
The face of a man who would absolutely do dark things to his fucking wife, dude. Who's totally sick of hearing that babble.
Hold on, so this dude killed her?
I mean, it hasn't been proven in a court of law. In fact, there's no evidence. And the fact there's no evidence...
If I must put up with her for one more day, I will murder this bitch.
Yep.
And,
Oh, my God.
Okay, you feel like, oh, my God. So you see she doesn't want
and
to
also,
eat.
And also, I eat only cheese in 2 days. Only cheese. Why you give me so much cheese, GM? You're like a Neil deGrasse Tyson. Is it like a blood for it?
Is this a woman that you would take to the public park and just drop off with the squirrels and the beavers?
You see, when the Chad man wants to murder his wife, you should let him murder her because the Chad man should be allowed to be Chad, dude, and to be dominant.
Here's the reality is, like, the last thing I want is for this guy to be innocent because of how big of a... I can't stand him. He is literally doing, like, Newsweek interviews and shilling his book about this.
Yeah.
To fuck this guy. And here's another thing. One time I had to spend $10 to get free shipping on Amazon, and I bought his book. I have the book. So here's the thing. If he's super guilty, I'll be able to sell the book. That's cool.
It's true.
Yep. Yeah, this is always the problem.
You're the only fucking person who bought that shit.
Yeah. So, like, what's the details behind this? Like, he...
She's retarded.
Okay. She's retarded.
Yeah,
She's dead. She's been gone since June. Okay. He dropped her off. Real deal, he dropped her off at the gas station because she wanted to go on an adventure. And she hasn't been seen in 3 months or heard from or any pings from social media or anything like that.
Dude, what the now, fuck?
How is that alien guy involved? The guy who is an alien or like a man in black?
I'm trying to get to that. Turned. I keep getting sidetracked. So
I was thinking that was your suspect.
I don't know what the fuck I downloaded, but I do have the clip. Give me one fucking second.
He got that bitch eating cheese, bro.
I know.
He wants her stuffed up.
Dude, so she has
Down syndrome, you also?
No. I don't know. There's no Down syndrome.
She's half retarded. She's half retarded.
Okay.
Yeah, her mom is retarded.
At first,
I just got my 23andMe back drunk. And I'm retarded.
Like, the kids are only a quarter retarded, so they're just right up there with the rest of America, you know?
Like, she acts like she's high.
Alright. Well,
retarded people
this.
Have an extra chromosome. She probably has, like, one less chromosome.
Let's watch this.
Fame anyone. This is what took place. These are the kinds of people they are. What we have to arrest. Is that Mama JF?
Oh, that's her.
I thought I heard something.
Oh.
He mutes. Fuck off, please. Please fuck off. Forcefully fuck off.
I had to mute Mama Jeff because she was telling some mean things about No White Guilt. I apologize. Everyone who's a fan of the show knows that Mama Jeff has an uncontrollable and irrational hate of No White Guilt. And we don't hate her for it. It's just a brain spark that she has where she construes No White Guilt as someone else. All right, Lawrence Forbes says, does Mama JF really have an issue with No White Guilt, or is she just fooling around? She has an actual issue.
Go away, please. Please fuck off. No, fuck off.
Don't say anything violent.
No, I want to get
What do you have to say?
No, I get seriously. You tried to kill me again.
Okay.
And I'm fucking sick that you're fucking me with me.
So... she thinks White Guilt is essentially stalking her because she says, kill me again. So he's around and he's been doing stuff, been trying to kill her.
You always follow me everywhere.
Shapeshifting.
All right.
And you say you want to make spiritual movement, but you fucking tried to kill me for 3 years.
Okay, so if No White Guilt ever tried to make spiritual movements with me, I'd shoot him in the fucking head.
All right, you're saying no white guilt, like not being guilty of being white. All right, that's
his name.
No white guilt.
That's
his Christian
birth certificate.
Name. Yeah.
What's that?
So, yeah, it gets weirder.
Like you're fucking psychopath, man.
Thomas, dit maintenant va-t'en. Okay, so the answer to the super chat is that Mama JF mistakes
she called him a psychopath.
No White Guilt for someone who has committed acts of violence against her. So that's why you see her currently sad.
Please fuck off now. Oh, man. Get the fuck out of here, you retard.
Mama JF has been the victim of an act of violence. It was not by No White Guilt at all.
But it's because No White Guilt looks like a default human. Like he was put through the human creator and they just left all the default options on.
I think that dude looks like a fucking freak.
Now, I don't
like,
know.
He's like...
But we'll just go on with the clip.
He's got weird cheekbones and weird eyes and like he smiles at the wrong times, and like he's just fucked. He's like, it's like,
it gets weird. Lizard Man. And I don't know if it's gonna hit it in this video.
If he hit meth,
how does it get weirder?
Well, we gotta listen to him.
Because she is confused, she associates Snow White guilt with.
Fuck off.
People are asking on the regular chat, is Mama JF okay? Yes, she is doing good. I don't know if she wants to come to say hi, but she is doing good. So no worries for Mama JF.
Wow.
Hello.
Hey, I just want to say, no, I will never accept your apologies, okay? What you did to me was so mean. And this guy is not a real person. He's doing shapeshifting, and he's a ghost.
He's based.
He's a fake person. He's shapeshifting, and he's a ghost.
I don't even think that she's retarded, dude. I think she's a highly evolved individual, and we're behind.
She
looks like she's got an extra chromosome. It's because she does. Which
she's kind of schizo. She's kind of
able to see through no white guilt, shapeshifting, camouflage.
I'm with you.
For the reptilian that he is.
I'm with you. This guy is from. He's the default character and the character creator, dude. Yeah, dude, that's the type of dude
that I would expect, like, you know, like, if you get black bagged, you know what I'm saying? Like, you get fucking extraordinarily rendered. Yeah. He's not the guy who will do the rendering. He's the guy that you fucking, he's the guy who takes the black bag off when you get to wherever you're there. Like, that's like, and he's smiling exactly like that. Like, how you doing? You know, like, that's this motherfucker. Like, he is
does give intent.
So, why'd you post this on Reddit? Why'd you do that? Huh? Why'd you do it? Why were you trying to say that?
So there's Mama JF.
Let's continue this. I want to get.
Why are you
the
posting the Talmud on X?
I don't know where this video goes, but I'm sure it'll be fun.
And this guy is not a real person. He's doing shapeshifting, and he's a ghost. Don't believe him. He's awesome. Not a real person.
Okay.
And he wants to kill me.
Okay. So no, my guilt is a ghost, according to Mama JF. I will say, as a journalist, I have a duty here not to allow defamation. And I will say that the theory that No White Guilt is a shape-shifting ghost is unsupported at the moment, in my view.
I disagree. All right,
we have a question for Mama.
It says in my view at the end.
K. Max McDonald says...
He gave her
Mama Jeff, what
I mean,
is your
she's
background?
Retarded, but she is
what country do you derive your ethnic heritage from?
She's a fucking doll, and her nudes are acceptable.
What?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Should I pull my
dog, brother? I don't know. I'm gonna have to disagree with you on that one, brother.
Doug, I would say the average woman has a worse figure than that, like significantly.
That's true.
That's probably true.
Because like we're fed fucking slop.
But,
yeah.
I can't answer that. Okay, before I had a bad life.
I think she's cute or whatever. I wouldn't go for
GF,
that.
Then I started to look at GF every day. I was always.
She's got a good. I think she's got a good spirit, dude. I do.
Lost everything I had. I lost my job, my family. I quit school. I lost everything. I was just looking at GF all the time, all the crazy. And then after I wrote to him, I said, GF, I want to suck your dick. And then he told me.
Oh my god.
She was so obsessed with the public space that she quit her job and disowned her family and DM'd JF saying, I want to suck your dick, and immediately moved in with them and made babies. Oh,
that's
I can see. Dude, that's pretty.
It's
big.
Fucking. That's a little.
Dog, here's the thing.
He's like,
I would find it acceptable if he was just a normal guy, but there is a weird combination of degeneracy and shamelessness, and like, because he's like flaunting that it's fucking that this shit's all fucked up, like on his streams. And like commenting to like bullshitting with chat about it, like I don't know. It's he's obviously very. He doesn't give a shit about it. He's cold and calculated. He is so autistic that he's sociopathic. He's into eugenics essentially. That's like his field is like DNA science or whatever the fuck. So like that's what he's into, and she's just for breeding purposes, and at the end of the day that's why you can slaughter the cow.
He got a breeding cow.
He's got a breeding cow.
So, yeah. How many kids does he have?
Two,
right?
Yeah, I could see, I could definitely see why.
My background.
You lost your job because you were addicted.
You lost everything because you were addicted
to my shows.
I was just looking at your show all the time. Even I had a job, and I was going to hide in the bathroom to listen to your show. And I was, then my boss said, "Why you always disappeared for 10 minutes? Then you fired me. I lost everything, my family, my friends, everything because I was."
She got
the thing is, like, if there's any women watching this show, please
DM Polak. Yeah.
Also, she
look at GS reaction to this. Well, like, she's like, I left everything. I fucking left my family.
This
my
is
life.
What I'm saying.
He's laughing his ass.
This
off.
Is exactly my point that I'm trying to make. Is like, look at the sincerity on her face, and look at the insincerity on his face.
Isn't he directly connected to Epstein?
He was paid like, I don't know, $20,000 or something to do like a YouTube thing for the Epstein Foundation or whatever the fuck it was.
Holy shit, that's fucking crazy.
Yeah, so he's connected to Epstein, like got money from Epstein, and now his wife's dead.
Yeah.
Case closed.
Yeah.
Like,
he was probably...
You've never told me that.
Yeah.
Wow. That is some dedicated fan right here.
That has anything to do with me being on the show. I'm due 4 days a week, plus not with the flat earth thing. That is how the agreement was. That is
jokers. See, Steve McRae was interested in the flat earth, which is very naive and beautiful. Hello, Mama Jeff. Oh, you took your shower?
Yeah, I was sleeping.
Yeah, so...
A-L-O-A-I-U!
Oh, yeah. She's a big fan of AIU.
He's so
she's so happy.
It's so nice
happy.
What you do, but
I don't know
why you're atheist.
Yeah, why are you an atheist, AIU?
He just fucking bossing.
She's just shitting on YouTubers because they're atheists and shit. It's awesome.
Like, this is... The thing is that, like... What's your perception of this guy?
He's
a fucking dork.
He's
a fucking dork.
He's a manipulative scumbag at best.
Yeah.
One at a time.
He's a tard breeder.
Yeah.
this woman's opinion of him is completely subjective. It's all contextual.
Her opinion of him is at his very fucking like will. Whatever he wants her to think of him, she will think. Because he's that manipulative and she's that dumb.
Yeah. Yeah. He's not a good guy.
She wanted to go live in the woods.
She's just so fucking happy. I mean, yeah, she says a bunch of weird shit, but like, I mean, that's pleasant.
I do. Yeah. She's like a weird, nice hippie chick, and like, dude, I love this shit. She is a magician in her own way. She makes this like outsider art out of like sticks and like trash and shit, and like that's like the Ashley Hatcher shit. But it's awesome. She would like bring out this like display of just like rotting sticks pointing everywhere, like on the streams. It was awesome.
There is such a thin line between retard and hippie. Like, it's literally, like, the tiniest line.
Yeah.
Like, just bringing sticks together and making a thing that's basically the same. That you're a hippie or a retard. I'm not sure which one.
Yeah, it's
either or.
Yeah, you definitely have to stay on top of this case. Yeah, come on.
I am. I'm checking every day.
I don't know what happened to Mama J.M.
It seems like he might have known what he was doing, getting rid of the body.
She probably got, like, kidnapped or killed or something.
Yeah, he probably... He probably got her.
She's probably in the White Guilt breeding program.
The White Guilt breeding program.
Yeah.
Reptilian fucking holding cell.
That's how you know she's not Jewish, is because she was part of like the white slavery breeding program.
She got lizard.com'd.
That's true.
Lizard
we're over here. I don't think I have any more JF content.
But, you know, so you think that's bad. What about the mantids?
Yeah, dude. We don't hear about them, dude. Let's watch. Let's take a breather here. And if you have to take a leak or anything, that would be the time. Let's watch the oldest horror movie ever made. It's only 3 minutes. So let's enjoy it.
Based. Let's watch it.
What the hell is it called? Let me give you a title. It's kind of important.
Not Caligari?
The Haunted Castle from 1896. Oh. Well, like I said, this is only like 3 minutes long, so I don't know if it counts as feature-length film.
Oh, it's in Polish.
All the best films are.
Wow. Fucking Marvel ain't got nothing on them.
I've been doing the silent, like I said, I've been doing the silent horror thing lately. I've been spooky horror from like the old days with synthwave playing. I highly recommend it.
They do all this with like stop motion. Like, how did they?
Well, that's the coolest thing is like trying to figure out how they did it, because you know it's something like you could do, but I don't know. It's all done so well. And like one thing I really love is all the pantomime, all of the acting they do with their bodies and their faces and stuff. That, it's just a lost art, and it's so cool. And it's aged so fucking well, because the vibe it gives off now, it's just 10 times better than it probably was.
It seems like, yeah, I was going to say, this seems like something way more modern than 18.
This is pretty esoteric here.
Hell yeah, bro. That dude's gone. How did they do that?
I don't know. Invisibility cloak.
I'm that guy. Oh, I'm that little weird guy who just popped up.
It's a little goblin man.
Literally me.
It's probably a Domovoy. I don't know.
I thought this was French.
I saw Polish like captioning.
It might be. Yeah, it probably is Polish, and I just have no idea what I'm looking at, honestly. Who knows?
I'm sure France has their own like weird house goblin thing too.
Ah, Jesus. Skeleton. He almost fucking...
Oh, damn. That's like fucking terrifying.
Gave that skeleton a fucking Woody. A boner. Missed opportunity to say boner.
Shit, he's a vampire. Or the house goblin back. Okay, so like the cloak can teleport. Right?
Yeah, I mean, well, yours can't. Spooky ghosts. They come and they go, dude.
He's a conjurer, too.
Yeah. He leveled up in conjuration. He's got the skill tree, like, maxed out.
He's a Breton mage.
Damn, girl. Is that a girl? I have no idea what I'm looking at.
Now she's like a witch, yeah. Yeah, now there's like 3 or 4 witches. There's 4 witches. Oh, they got brooms now.
Dude. If you don't, guys, don't be lacking. If you're a witch, you can't be called lacking with no broom. How are you going to do your magic? Obviously, this wasn't the music at the time. Put anything you want on this. You could put on Puddle of Mud.
Or Wave. Oh, he's got the friggin'
dude, crucifix. You bow to your king, bro. King Jesus. That's right, dude. I want to do more horror movie content as we go on here, dude. I've been dying to do some movie reviews. I've been saying that for weeks, but I think it's coming up. You're talking about doing Mandy, which I haven't seen, Nicolas Cage. Nicolas Cage, dude. I was on some I was on some random Rumble stream with like a retarded guy who was playing like Ethereum browser games. And I told him he was a national treasure. I was like, what's the national treasure? What's that? And I'm like, dude, if I was Nicolas Cage, I would kidnap you. And who's Nicolas Cage? Who's Nicolas Cage? I'm like, he was a patriot during the Civil War, dude. He started rambling about the Civil War, and like he didn't understand what I was talking about, and I'm like, dude,
there's going to be a Civil War 2. He's like, is it a video game? I'm like, no, dude. Nah. He's like, who's playing it? And I'm like, dude, same team, rematch. So Rumble is good for things once in a while, dude. You have to interface with the retarded people, my fellow retarded people. Thank God for Rumble.
Like, do we have any, like, what was the conclusion we came up with about Cobes?
The hell you mean? There ain't no conclusion yet. Botulism is likely.
Botulism's gonna be the conclusion, yeah.
The botulism arc.
Yeah, he's gonna chug that rotten ass banana punch mead he's trying to make and get
banana punch.
Dude, he was making
it's mead like a fucking whole banana.
Dog. He was making mead with Reese's Pieces.
Reese's Pieces.
It's not a joke. That's what he's doing now. He's gonna die.
He's gonna die.
Can't put Reese's Pieces in fucking in Tropico juice with honey. Yeast. Yeah, and baker's yeast. What the fuck is going on over here, dog? He's dead meat, bro. Whatever.
What do you think his fucking bathroom looks like?
Oh, dude, come on now. I don't even want to consider, bro.
Probably like.
Let's move on to the aliens, bro. Let's do aliens. We're talking about aliens and that fucking boglem.
He is an alien, basically.
It turns out that those Mexican mummies, those fake-ass Mexican mummies, the speculation is now, after scientists have gotten their hands on this thing, is that
they're cake?
Yeah, they're cake.
They're cake.
Fuck, dude. The skulls look like alpaca skulls.
What?
That they fashioned into alien skulls. Because that's the thing, they used all, like, biologic material to make this shit. They didn't use fake stuff, really. They just kind of put fake stuff on it, I guess, the plaster of Paris. But inside, the bones were all real, and it was like children bones and an alpaca skull. Explain this, Flame. Why would your people do this?
They did a legit human sacrifice and then made it look like some alien bullshit in order to make it more.
But like that, I mean, I guess it's possible. I mean, alpacas don't. Well, I guess you could have an alpaca anywhere, right?
Is that you're not getting off the hook that easy. The Peruvian government wants the mummies back because they are allegedly stolen Incan artifacts. So the Peruvian government will corroborate that they are actually sacrificed children from the Incan days.
You know, that doesn't sound too dissimilar, because I was reading about mummies that were found in like Chile, and they were they're like the clay mummies, and like these they're like barely mummies because it's like they took the skin of the person and they like stretched it over like a fucking clay doll or something. And it almost reminds me of that. Yeah, in Chile. Yeah.
Chile is back in the day was part of the Inca Empire. So like Chile and the southern part of Peru are like the desert area where those mummies come from. Because like during around that area they had a ritual for rain, if I believe.
Gotta kill them kids.
I remember right.
So what
their practices were so fucking like so fucking weird or something. It was like they would choose like the way they selected the mummies for that sacrifice was they found the most attractive child. And,
Epstein did. That's what I'm saying.
Epstein, just the Incan.
They would have $65,000 of hot dogs, and they would just throw them down the pyramids. They would fall down the steps like slinkies.
Epstein was the last.
Yeah, dude.
Yup.
The last Incan.
That's what his temple was. I don't think Incan I have any temple. More alien content. I think that's the aliens. Cool.
Incan temple.
Done. Finished. How about this, dude? I found this article. I've been looking for the Loch Ness Monster for 3 years, and I have never found anything conclusive. Here's why I sit for hours in the rain anyway. Hate my wife.
That's fucking dark.
It's that simple, dude. It's that simple. Let's see what his reasoning is. Well, first of all, Alan McKenna organizes Loch Ness Exploration, a group of for monster hunters as well as skeptics. They're inclusive. He's followed the Nessie myth for years, but has never had its sighting. Here's why he's still fascinated by the log. Let me see if it actually is his wife. Otherwise, I don't give a shit. He likes eels. He believes. He's a believer. Hates his wife. Believes in the Loch Ness Monster. I've summed it up for you. We've cracked the case. That's why he sits out in the
rain. You gotta believe in something.
Alright, so fuck the Loch Ness Monster. That shit's fake. Let's talk about Bigfoot. New Bigfoot sighting.
Loch Ness Monster has what meat?
New Bigfoot sighting. So this...
Holy shit, that's just a guy in a ghillie suit.
Shut up, don't ruin the magic for me. It's like telling me Santa Claus isn't real, dog. You're a fed.
I don't know.
I know now.
I saw like...
You're going to tell me a swamp gas next. It's a
no, let me say, like, what made me say that is if you look at, like, the way the pants or the leg hair is.
I know.
It's almost like there's a waistline.
Well...
That's what I was saying.
I would say that this is almost too good of camouflage. It's almost like he bought this specifically for this terrain. You know?
That's what I was thinking too, because it looks just like, yeah, like a ghillie suit for that terrain.
Alright, so before we tell kids that Santa's not real, let's watch this video.
A couple was on that sightseeing train between Durango and Silverton. They were trying to spot elk when they saw this creature that they could only describe as Bigfoot. 6-7 feet tall, they say. Camouflaged. Now, okay, I mean, if you really look closely, I don't know what else to describe it as. Look.
That is crazy.
Right?
It's time to go. It's time to pack
and go. Someone's in a costume out there freaking people out. It's a comedian.
I don't care. Either way, it was time to go.
I think it's a prankster. The train's conductor tried to say, you know what, we've seen footprints in the snow before. Some people thought it was a hunter, but I don't see a weapon on that.
That's what I thought.
I believe it's Bigfoot. I believe someone is making us into just jokesters. Whoa,
I see two fucking guns, and it's that girl in the green.
Not even anywhere near.
Hashtag costume. Who knows? Oh, it could be Bigfoot. You never know.
It's Bigfoot, dude. Girl? We got Bigfoot, bro. Bigfoot confirmed, dude. And yet, look, it's a guy in a ghillie suit. I don't know. No, I wanted to believe for a split second. Dude, why do you keep doing the ice bit? I need you to stop doing the ice bit. Fucking, yeah.
It's just like Matt bit.
So I wanted to believe for a second when like the Forestry Service came out and they like dismissed it completely like a joke. And I'm like, oh, it's got to be real. But no, yeah, it's a guy in a ghillie suit, no doubt. Look, it got me 1,000 views on fucking TikTok in like an hour. Like, whatever. I'll tell the world. I want to be weekly world news on TikTok. Now, some call that fake news these days, but I call it lying. For shits and giggles.
I call it lying.
For a laugh. Yeah. I don't give a shit, dude.
Oh, shit. Fucking great.
I have more Bigfoot content somewhere.
Followed by Lego Masters at 8 p.m.
Let's read this. I got a
Lego Masters.
I got a fucking story about Sasquatch from Somerset County, Raritan, New Jersey, which is not a common place to have Bigfoot sightings in New Jersey, but they are there. Oh, the Pine Barrens are a big
place.
There's
a Joisey Squatch?
Let me read this from BigfootEncounters.com. I have never been one for having an interest in the unknown or the paranormal, but when someone you trust tells of an experience from their past, sometimes you have to give them the benefit of the doubt. I was reading your True Tales about a month ago and came across a story that took place in New Jersey on or about the area of Doris Duke Farms. After reading it, my jaw dropped because the story gave the one that was told to me some validity. My grandfather told me the story back in 91, a few years before he passed away, and so it goes. My grandfather worked from the late 50s to the early 70s as a landscaper on the Duke Estate in Somerset, New Jersey. When he told the story to my sister and me, he was foggy when giving the exact dates, but he was still very sharp and explained it with incredible detail. My grandfather's job was to manicure and care for the lawns in the north section of the property, whatever that meant, and other various duties. He said that in the summer of 72, on an August afternoon, he was told by the head groundskeeper that he would be working overtime and that he was needed because a shipment was being delivered from Wisconsin. They needed about 8 men to unload a crate and to bring it into the garden area. That night, the truck arrived and it was getting late. The men who were asked to stay for overtime were eager to get things done and over with and be on their way. When the truck pulled up, my grandfather said that the crate was about 8 feet tall and 5 feet wide. When he asked what was inside it, the one in charge said they were exotic trees. What happened next was enough to make half of the team get up and walk off the job and not care about the consequences. When the men started pushing the crate off the flatbed truck, a blood-curdling scream was unleashed from within the box. All of the men let go of their grip and the crate fell to the floor. As everyone jumped back, realizing that this was anything but a tree, the head keeper did all he could to save the content's real identity and said that there was a black bear inside of it. While the men were regaining their composure, most of the help walked off the job. They said they didn't want to get hurt or mauled dealing with a wild animal without the proper safety equipment, so off they went, including my grandfather. Only 2 men stayed to finish what they were asked. This is what was told to my grandfather. The 2 remaining men managed to get the load onto a dolly and then drag it into the garden compound. While guiding the crate down the main path, balance was lost and the crate came off the wheels. The crate hit hard enough to crack the side of it and loosen the side panel, which fell off and exposed the contents. What the 2 remaining men witnessed that night was enough to make them seek employment elsewhere. What I am telling you was how it was told to me. Inside the crate sat a creature that had the shape of a man, but was anything but a man. They couldn't give a height measurement since the creature was in sitting position, but they said it was huge. It had the shape of a man with a very large frame, only it was covered with black hair. The creature was strapped down and had shackles on his legs and feet and arms. The face didn't look like a man, but had some human features. The workers said it looked more like a monkey or a gorilla. The hair was extremely long and dirty. At one point, one of the men said they thought that this thing was trying to speak or communicate with words, but all it did was keep on drooling. They were under the impression that this creature was heavily sedated because it couldn't keep his head up straight. It rested its head on its chest. A couple of inches away from the creature's head was an empty water bottle nailed to the wall. On the other side of the creature was an IV stand connected to the wall and stuck to its arm. It might have been used to feed this creature during its transport. One of the oddest parts to the story was that my grandfather was told that this creature was sitting on a rocking chair. I could never understand this. After thinking about it, though, I think it was maybe to prevent this thing from getting cramps during the move. They also said that the odor was overpowering and enough to make anyone pass out. The combined smell of urine, waste, body odor, and cum was rank. My grandfather stuck by this story till the very end. About 2 weeks before he passed away, my sister reminded me to bring it up again and confront him, which I did. There was no need to go over the story again because we both know how it went. I just asked him, "Papa, remember the crate you had to move in Jersey?" He just looked at me, smiled, and said, "Of course." I said, "Did you embellish at all?" He said, "No, there was no reason to. It happened the way I said it happened." I said, "Because now would be the time to tell me." He looked up at me and said, "You want to know if I embellish the story? The truth is that I am guilty of the opposite. There was so much that I left out. The story was just the beginning. Remember something. I worked there for 2 more years after that. There are things that a young mind should not hear." I said, "But I am not a child anymore. I am sure I can handle what it is you have to say." Grandfather said, "Tomorrow I will finish the story. Come back tomorrow." But there was no tomorrow. Grandfather passed away at 2 a.m. that morning in a New York hospital. This is a true story from Ray V.
It almost reminds me of that one story about Bigfoot getting in like a forest fire and they have to give him an IV to like fucking keep him alive.
Yeah, I think there are strange menageries and underground bases and on weird estates. I think people have real-life cat girls in their captivity. I think there are chimeras, combinations of different DNA and different, like, animals combined. Alex Jones talks about seeing that. I believe it.
Yeah, I've heard that one.
So it wouldn't surprise me if in some weird menagerie somewhere they had Bigfoot and that this thing was like traded underground in the black market or something. I don't know.
Yeah, Alex, remember the Romanian Wendigo?
Cat girl in real life?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Dude, oh, cat there's girls. Like a zoo in Romania. Cat girls? Fucking
there's cat boys.
You saw a cat boy in real life?
Yeah, Alex Jones.
Alex Jones did.
Alex Jones. Nick Fuentes.
Nick, yeah. It was Nick Fuentes. Yeah, it was Nick Fuentes.
Yeah, that's what happened.
Alex Jones person. You see the fucking AI thing where it's got Alex Jones and a hardcore band?
Dude, people on like the very schizo side of Instagram are trying to like expose, say that Alex Jones is, I mean, of course Alex Jones is some kind of shill, but like specifically because he like probably fucks trans people, that he's that's why he's a shill. The reason why he's
here's the reality of that, dude. They blackmail and prop up degenerates.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely.
So it's not, but like, yeah, it's not that that's like why. That's just like why he's, yeah, they can blackmail him for, because he's a fucking sexual deviant who does loads of cocaine and jerks off to trannies.
Right.
But that's not why
he was saying it backwards.
Yeah.
This dude was saying that like the Alex Jones is there for me and you to get into and get into his conspiracy theories so that we can become like him and start fucking trans people.
No, well, that's insane. Yeah, at this point, backwards. Like, at this point, Alex Jones is a bit of a pressure release valve, so you can get into it, you can have your outlet, but it never goes too far. But the fact of the matter is that I'd say about 50% of the people in these circles, whatever you want to call them, the conspiracy circles, even the alt-right circles, everything, everything that's like in that milieu, 50% of those people are there because they saw Alex Jones at some point.
Yep.
If he had like a billion views on his YouTube channel before it got shut down. A billion views. Yeah. 1 in 7 people on Earth saw Alex Jones. That's crazy. That's nuts.
I remember in his prime, there was nothing else like it.
His early days were great. It was classic. It was wonderful. Yeah.
He like beat the shit out of papers on his desk. It was great. Beat the shit.
He had Tex Mars as like he had Tex Mars officiate his wedding, and like I don't want to elaborate on how insane that is, but that's so fucking cool.
God damn, I think it's really a sign of that time too, because like the kind of rage content he was doing, I don't think we could do like the shit we do is like way more chill.
Yeah.
And most like conspiracy theorists that I see that get any kind of like traction, it's a completely different presentation of it. But he was just like trying to take like some kind of like Fox News type of energy of like
he's fucking liberal.
And like you can't really do that now.
Things have gone too far. If I do it now, suddenly I'm saying all sorts of shit that can get me banned.
Right.
You know, Alex Jones got banned, and that's like the tame stuff.
He took all his money, fucking wrecked his life.
Yeah, I don't know. If you're like an angry figure yelling at something, now that sells. And sometimes I get into that mode, but the thing is, like, I can't hold it, or I would just say horrible things that get me kicked the fuck off every platform. The people who get by doing that are propped up by money. Outside sources. Well, he's not even an example. I don't even know what the fuck he's an example of. He seems to have fallen off the face of the earth.
I don't know. I think Fuentes was propped up by Fed money at one point.
They all were. Every alt-right organization was. They were all getting giant crypto donations that they couldn't trace. And they were just happy to receive them.
I remember like hearing about him out of fucking nowhere. Yeah.
Once again, Fuentes' thing was that he was a 17-year-old who could hold his own in a debate. He's not 17 anymore, and he can't hold his own in debate. So,
no.
What the fuck good is he? I don't
know. He's good at being like, he's good at jerking off the trannies, apparently.
No, he's out of the picture. And eventually, he'll come back and try to rebrand himself, and we'll all make fun of him until he gets kicked off the internet forever. But, yeah, no, he's out of the picture. The whole alt-right thing has been completely fucking destroyed and put into shambles. They made sure everybody who was propped up was like, the worst example of a leader you could possibly imagine. They made sure they were all people who sounded real good in their echo chamber of a few hundred people. But if you put them in, like, dude, they're just nothing but fucking sound bites that could just get them destroyed on the media at any given moment. Just get laughed.
Do you remember
off the
what
stage.
Happened to the traditional workers' party?
Yes, the box broke.
That was Matt. Wasn't that the fat guy, Matt Hambach?
Yeah, he was fat.
Yeah.
He like he was fucked also a cop, wasn't he? Huh? He fucked.
To be honest, I've seen.
He fucked his stepmom. Like he literally.
Oh
fucked
yeah,
his stepmom.
That's what it was. Yeah. He fucked his
and
stepmom.
His father walked Matt in Harris. On him, and Matt, he like yeah. beat that was... his stepmom. His father walked in on him fucking his stepmom, and he beat his father's ass.
Yeah. Now, but the thing is, I like.
Matthew Heimbach.
So Heimbach was the son-in-law, and Matthew Parrott was the father who the box right. broke on. That's what happened.
So yeah. technically not his father, his stepfather, but he fucked his. Yeah.
So and that was the moment that like their trailer park commune went up in smoke because they had to run to Walmart to be safe from each other or something. I don't remember. Yeah, no, that's the thing, is like any group that comes to power is propped up by the weird sources, and the fact is all of the heads of these things are people that can just be annihilated in a public setting at any given moment. That's why they're so good.
Yeah.
Because they can hold their own when they're talking in front of their people. They can make people believe that they're an actual leader. But they can just be destroyed any moment. They're not that good. And that's all of the leaders now.
Yeah, it's also their political positions are not great. Like, a corrupt politician can actually be taken down by a person who knows what they're fucking talking about, but not if that person is saying, like, we need to have a weird, like, union of, like, communism and Nazism.
Yeah,
exactly. Like, that's what Matthew Heimbach was saying. Like, it's like, you can't really, like, advocate for that shit in a public setting and not get trounced.
The
like,
issue is that not only... is there no political solution? But you also the most retarded political solution won't work either, it turns out.
Yeah.
If you use the dumbest strategy possible, that's also not really going to get you very far.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude. I don't know.
If these people...
Yeah, it's like the two biggest things American boomers have been told to hate, so like they're not going to respond well to it. Yeah.
Well, who the fuck would? What rational fucking person possibly could?
Going back to the Israel stuff, one of the rhetorical gestures that I think the alt-right had that was pretty smart was saying, and I mean, obviously it would be to my detriment if this happened, but, you know, they would say things like, what if we had Israel for white people and stuff like that? And like, it presented like a kind of like a problem that like mainstream people would have to solve in their heads, but it was never going to fucking go anywhere. But it was like, why is it that Israel is allowed to be an ethnostate, but we're not allowed to be, you know, like shit like that. That's the only kind of rhetorical purpose.
That's
of the
point. Yeah.
Beyond that, they didn't accomplish anything.
These arguments are fucking useless. I'll say that first and fucking foremost. The fact of the matter is that argument might make Israel look bad, but it will never make nationalists look good.
You know,
in the mainstream eye, which so it's basically fucking pointless, just right from the go. And here's the other thing is like I said before, like if my people controlled Israel, I'd probably support it too. And while I stand by that, I don't particularly want to control Israel or give a shit about it. And I don't think there's like the amount of people who actually give that much of a shit. And like, who actually want? If like, yeah, I would want to take Israel. There, that sentiment does not exist. I would say
no one gives a shit about it.
Well, America, as far as like regular people, almost everybody is against imperialism to some extent. Now they might also like be two-faced and also support it because the media told them to. But almost everybody knows that going and fucking around in weird countries is a bad idea. Like, we learned our lesson. I really think that if that wasn't the case, I think they would have been able to go to war with Iran when they wanted to.
Right.
And now we're at a point, I think, Iran's too powerful. We couldn't go to war with them. I think we would do worse in a war against Iran than we would with Russia, because there's probably a larger contingent of people in Russia who are dissatisfied with Putin than there are in Iran who are dissatisfied with the Ayatollah. I would say that the theocracy alone makes them almost impenetrable to our PSYOP meddling ever again. They fell to it once, and they put in a construct of power to make sure that never happened again, being the Ayatollah, who is in contact with the Mehdi, who is God's like final judge for mankind. It's a divine position. And the people there who are Shias, Shia Islam is essentially the state religion for Iran. That's what it exists as today.
Wait, so what is the Mehdi?
The Mehdi is a messianic figure. You can kind of think it in terms of like the way Jesus returns, but
right.
At the same time in Islam, Jesus does return. He's a separate figure from the Mehdi, but the Mehdi is it. If I remember right,
there's no person that's the Mehdi right now, right? Like unless people have like declared themselves to be that.
That's the thing. And now the Mehdi is essentially the brains to Jesus' brawn. Jesus comes and kills the Antichrist, but the Mehdi is like head of the state that like Jesus is leading in a war against the Antichrist.
He's Bran. Bran is Stark.
He's Gandalf.
Okay. He's Bran and Stark.
And no, Gandalf's not head of state, but like that's always the example that Muslims use when they say the Lord of the Rings is like an image of all of this.
Yeah.
And that fucking Aragorn is the Jesus figure, the return of the king. And then Gandalf is the Mehdi figure, is usually how it's propped up. Yeah, I don't know exactly. Okay. There's a lot of ways to look at it. But the thing is, now most Muslims, I think the standard Sunni opinion is that the Mehdi's not here yet, or if he is, we don't know who it is yet. There are many branches that will say that they have people in contact with the Mehdi and he is here. There are schools of Islam like Ahmadiyya who, like their founder said, he was the Mehdi. And now there's like the Baha'i faith. Baha'i faith was founded by a guy who said he was the Mehdi. So there's a lot of controversy about this. And especially when you have a lot of war in the region, there's a lot of apocalypticism. And there are people who spring up as like guerrilla fighters in Iraq who are claiming that they're the Mehdi and they have like a decent following and shit like that. Talking about the Antichrist Dajjal series and Abdullah Hashem. Like he was in contact with a Mehdi figure who was also like an Iraqi freedom fighter or whatever the fuck, who allegedly died in Iraq. And now there's a big war over like his lineage right now. It's very interesting. But
yeah, I heard about like the fucking Iraqi Mehdi thing. Yeah.
What sets Shia Islam apart is that because it is all based out of like a hierarchy within Iran, the Ayatollah is the highest ranking figure in Shia Islam. And he is in contact with the Mehdi, if not physically, spiritually.
Okay. Yeah, it's like one of those.
It's like a pope thing. I don't know.
Yeah.
He's the pope.
Well,
so he's the pope of Shia Islam.
You brought up Russia, and like Russia, like you think about like Dugin with Russia. Yeah. Dugin is basically trying to make sense of things in Russia in a way that like Iran already fucking has theocracy and like a theocratical state that is going to fucking justify what it's doing. And Dugin is trying to make all these like all these weird gestures, and it's like, what the fuck is Russia but like just like not the US? It's just like it's versus Iran, which is like a fucking Muslim state. It's a Shia Muslim state specifically, which puts them in a very like specific, like they have a destiny that kind of like makes sense.
I think Russia is very much taking cues from Iran. I think when you see Russia call it a holy war against the West, that is Iran. That's the great Satan. It's the same vibe.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I think, yeah, there's very much, like, they can see the way it is. Like, the only way to combat our like, subversive mind control is, like, overt nationalistic mind control, I guess, is like kind of the way they're seeing it. Do you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Like they don't have the resources to send the CIA.
I would say like it makes sense.
They don't have the resources to send their CIA to every country on earth and like overthrow them. Yeah. So it's the same thing as like China. China, like their entire society is based on like nationalism and their essentially social credit score and shit like that. Their state is essentially a theocracy in a lot of ways.
Mm.
Yeah.
It's a communist theocracy.
Yeah, you know, it's tailored to the people for the time, for the place. But yeah, and it's in the same way in a lot of ways, like we have this almost materialistic theocracy where there's a dogma to it. And you're not even allowed to say certain things because it just goes against the times or whatever the fuck.
Right.
But ours is so insidious. It's the prison where you can't see the bars. That's why I was always like, as someone who's just only known this horrible system, like there's something to be jealous of when I look at like an overt dictatorship and I'm like, well, at least I know what line not to cross.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Whereas this one's changing every day. And I don't know what I'm allowed to say. Yeah. I have no idea. And in some places, just don't talk shit on the state. It's very easy.
Kind of though, in a lot of ways. But I feel you. I feel what you mean by that. But in China, it's like here we have a democracy. There they have a communist party that has democracy within it. And you can vote if you're a member of the party. And they have relative freedoms. And a corporation can do what it wants, et cetera. But if they do something the government doesn't like, the government comes in and fucks them. So they don't really tell you what to not do. You just see other people going to prison in China. You see people going to the gulag for different shit. And then you say, oh, I better not do that shit. They don't have laws that say that you can't like be corrupt. I mean, like they have like a loose notion of corruption, but it's basically like, you know, you basically fucked around and found out, basically.
Yeah,
so it's kind of a weird parallel to what we have. But I think that I would agree more to what you're saying about Iran, about like it being an overt kind of totalitarian theocracy. And there's a certain comfort there in living under that, because at least you know what it is, versus this is like a deception.
I also think there is a intrinsic tendency to value your citizenry more with the overt thing. Do you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Because like, if they know whose door to come knock on with the pitchforks and the torches,
right?
You know what I mean? Then there is some stake in that. Mm-hmm. I think that's why that's why the feudal system worked, essentially. You know, but the way we have it here, it's like if you got an issue, there is nobody to go to.
No, there's no
all,
one
all you can
to.
Do.
No one cares.
Is beg for government assistance. Nobody will ever right the wrong. They might throw you a little bit of money so you can suck the government teeth and shut the fuck up. But there is no one who's accountable for anything. And we can look at this on like a low level and like you can just like, you know, the way we talk about free speech on social media and stuff. Like if you're banned, you're banned. There's nobody to go appeal that to usually. Once in a while you get lucky, but it's really just a roll of the dice. And it's the same thing if you get fucked over at your job and you need unemployment, you are rolling the fucking dice. If you need fucking disability, workman's comp, like, you know, you're just rolling the fucking dice. Is the person who's going to look at this like lazy enough to just put it through? Because who the fuck cares?
Yeah.
Yep.
Right? Like, if I told you, and I don't want to go into it because it might be a bad idea, but if I told you what like I've put on unemployment forms where I was like, there's no way they're gonna give me money for this, and they gave me money, like, dude, you'd laugh your ass off at how stupid this shit is. I'll tell you off air. I'm not saying it right now.
Okay,
it's ridiculous. It's so stupid. And then my girlfriend had a problem where she was injured and she like really could have used like help, and it would have been totally justified, and like, no fucking way. It's just pass on that shit, dude. It makes no sense, to be honest.
Fuck, man.
So that's why you just gotta loot this dying empire while you can.
Yeah, dude. If everybody was able to declare what they wanted, like what they're owed for like welfare and shit like that, the whole welfare system would get completely fucked.
Yeah, no, there's the money's not there. That's why we know Social Security's dying, all that shit. The money's simply not there. They've stretched themselves too thin. They know they've done it.
Yep.
All right. Chupacabra sighting.
I'll be right back.
Oh, based, my favorite Coyote cryptid.
Let's watch this motherfucker. Did I have the video? Do I not have the video for this?
No,
I didn't download the video. Well, I can tell you about it.
Well,
I want to find the video. Can I do it fast enough? Fuck me.
Let's do it. We got Jack had to like go do something anyway, so
well,
we can bullshit and find it until he comes back.
All right. Chupacabra, Brazilian That should be a good.
Oh, I was in Brazil. That's
dude,
fucking
we got the Brazilian chupacabra happening right now, dude. If you believe.
I know there's one from like Puerto Rico, and it's more lizard like.
Well, that's the OG.
It's like a reptilian.
One. Yeah, that's the original
yeah.
one. Yeah, this one is fucking weird. And there's probably a very simple answer for it. But once again, I don't want to just like. I don't want to.
You hear about like the fucking dog XM thing? The like the fucking fox dog hybrid that they just proved can happen?
Yeah, it sounds like one of those things that's Brazil. Possible, yeah. But very, very unlikely. So if it did happen, I wouldn't be shocked.
Yeah, they did. They found an actual living example. They did DNA tests. Yeah.
That's cool.
And they come up to the conclusion that like the fucking DNA sequencing or whatever with foxes and dogs is like just barely fucked up enough to where it kind of works but doesn't. So like this very rare pup somehow lived even though its DNA is all like not in line essentially.
Dog, I've heard the claim. Hold on, let me pause this for a second before we do this. I've heard the claim that it is technically possible for like a human and a chimp to breed. It's just that it happens so rarely and it's so extremely unlikely is the reason we haven't seen it. But I've heard it's like
technically
possible.
Yeah, I mean like Stalin was trying to create fucking humanzies.
Yeah. Me too. All right.
Humanzies.
You guys ready for this fucking chupacabra video?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
We got news. Baby.
Hunters in Brazil claim to have killed an elusive
AI
chupacabra,
voice.
Also
what
known
the
as
fuck?
The goat sucker. That is reported to have been a problem for local farmers. News.com has learned that the hunters filmed the deceased creature and shared the footage online. Video appears to show a creature with human-like hands, razor-sharp teeth, and a body roughly the size of a large monkey, according to the Daily Star. Hunters explained that they encountered the chupacabra while hunting wild boar on the outskirts
like
of town.
That looks nothing
they
like
claimed
it,
to
yeah.
have chased the creature, and their hunting dogs fought with it before one hunter shot it. The video was filmed as proof that the chupacabra did exist and was now in fact dead. Not everyone is convinced that the creature is a legendary chupacabra. Some skeptics believe it could be the decomposing body of a howler monkey, which is native to the forests of South and Central America.
Poor little feller.
Howler monkeys are commonly found in the area and are known to eat leaves.
Well, here's the big problem I'm saying. I don't even feel like I need to keep showing this, but this is supposedly an animal that they just killed. Why is its skull hanging out? Why is it decomposing?
Yeah, what the fuck?
Why is it like it's been sitting there for a month? Why has this monkey been sitting there rotting for a month? And they brought it onto the fucking national news for the people, dude.
This is an Ashley's house. That's why it's rotten.
That's true. That's true. It is the mummified howler pork. Monkey from Ashley's house.
Yeah, mummified howler monkey.
That's true. Christ. Disgusting, dude. So it's not one. It's either another breed of, you know that, what it actually looks like rather than like fake chupacabra. It looks like what the hell was that thing called?
Taco Bell?
The Plum Island Monster or whatever. I feel like that's not what it was called, but it was like the critter had like a parrot beak that
monster?
Like no, it washed up on the shores in like some island in New
oh,
York.
Oh, I remember that. It looked like a fucking like crocodile with human hands.
Montauk Monster.
Yeah. Yeah, it looked
the
like
Montauk
a
Montauk Monster. This motherfucker is a Montauk Monster. Way out of its own range.
I'm eating Taco Bell right now and it looks very comparable.
just like that boy.
I use chupacabra meat. Probably the finest. Do.
Same shade of orange and like yellow.
We gotta queue up something to listen to, dude. We gotta queue up something to go out with. Okay, I'm just gonna do play Limp Bizkit and it'll just play something.
Limp Bizkit. Yeah, we'll do some Limp
Bizkit. Let's see what it picks. What will the bot pick? We got Break Stuff, dude. You know what it
Break
it
Stuff.
Is.
Break
Rape Stuff.
It's one of those things.
Yeah, so you're gonna fucking rip someone's head off, dude. I'm trying to find if I have any more facts that I forgot to read. Is to stay away, motherfucker. One of those streams. Yeah, dude. Big time.
One of those streams.
Are we allowed to play this shit?
I don't give a shit anymore. they'll just make sure I can never monetize anything ever again, but they'll let me play because it sells albums, dude. This is how he makes money now. So, fucking Limp Bizkit, avid proponents of file sharing. Thanks, guys. I utilize that privilege much as a child. Durst also found Cold, found Stained, found Puddle of Mud, all mistakes. She Wants Revenge. That's a pretty good band, actually.
Wait, he made that?
Yeah, he is the lead singer of She Wants Revenge.
Okay. Dude.
Not really.
That's a good,
he discovered them and signed them.
They're kind of like annoying goth pop band. I like them kind of.
I was listening to them back in the day, I want to say like 2010 or whatever, they sound like a goth band. They sounded like post-punk.
Yeah.
I don't know what they sound like now.
Yeah, they're like a goth, like, you know, they're kind of goth that gets on the radio.
Yeah, I don't know. It was decent.
Yeah.
While Limp Bizkit was on hiatus, Durst began working on independent films. In 2006, Durst co-starred in film Population 436. Directorial debut, The Education of Charlie Banks, was released the following year, which starred Jesse Eisenberg. Mixed reviews. Then he did The Long Shots. One of these fucking movies is about like an autistic person. So he's done like two movies about retarded people.
Autistic people. Fred Durst.
I don't know what's up with that. So
Fred Durst, the Chris Chan documentary.
We were talking about The Fanatic earlier. Another
good
mixed
morning, up. America.
Ah,
so exciting to be here.
Alb is here, dude. Do you know Fred Durst made a movie, two movies about retarded people, and then Red Letter Media gave them mixed reviews? The fuck is up with that?
I know Red Letter Media.
We're just in time for us to end the fucking stream, dude.
Well,
Red Letter Media is
what?
Howler Monkeys.
Dude, I'm not convinced.
Are commonly found in the area, and they are known to eat leaves, fruits, nuts, and flowers.
This is more swamp gas, dude. This is bullshit.
Swamp gas.
I'll catch y'all next week. Thanks, everybody, for streaming. We hanging out. We gonna get